Start by choosing a permanent marker to use for the procedure. Place the dish under the microscope and carefully put the pen under the dish and above the lens. Using 4x magnification, look for spontaneously differentiated cells within the iPSC culture. The low magnification makes it easier to scan the plate in an efficient manner. Give preference to a marker with a broader tip to mark the differentiated areas. To make this setting more stable, rest the marker on the edge of the lens. Once you've placed your marker under the dish and are able to see the shadow of the marker, use it to mark the differentiated regions. Move the dish to change the field of view and keep marking the unwanted spontaneously differentiated regions until you cover as many as possible. Before starting the procedure, learn to distinguish spontaneously differentiated cells from iPSC colonies. Remember that they have distinct features as compared to iPSC colonies. You can revise these features in our video called Assessing Morphology. Briefly, iPSC colonies are formed by densely packed cells with defined borders. At a higher magnification, it is clear that these cells present a high nucleus to cytoplasmic ratio and have a prominent nucleolus. Depending on the day you observe the culture, the colonies may or may not be densely packed, but you should still be able to distinguish iPSCs from spontaneously differentiated cells. Regions of spontaneous differentiation can be identified as regions of irregular cell morphology within a colony, causing a loss of border integrity of the iPSC colony. You might also find these cells forming a colony on their own. Depending on the thickness of the tip of the marker you used, you might not be able to mark only the differentiated regions, especially when the differentiated cells are bordering the iPSC colonies, but keep marking anyway. It is preferable to lose a few good colonies than to have too many differentiated regions in the dish. The accumulation of spontaneous differentiation compromises the quality of the iPSC culture. If regions of spontaneous differentiation are more than 25% of the total culture, follow the releaser protocol instead. In blue are the selected regions to be removed. In this case, the percentage of regions of spontaneous differentiation is less than 25%, so they will be removed manually. To remove the previously marked regions, use a 200 microliter sterile pipette tip inserted into a pipette or attached to a vacuum aspirator. A sterile cell scraper can also be used. In this protocol, we will use the pipette method. Open the dish and scrape off the regions previously marked, carefully and one by one. Repeat this procedure until you scraped all the marked regions. After scraping off all the regions you marked, the scraped cells will now be floating on the dish and it will be aspirated once you remove the media by vacuum aspiration. In case of a dish with a high percentage of regions of spontaneous differentiation, wash the cells with warm DMEM to eliminate the debris. In this dish, however, there were not a lot of differentiated regions, so there is no need to wash the cells. In either case, add the appropriate iPSC media to the dish before storing the cells in the cell culture incubator. 3 milliliters of iPSC media is added per 6-centimeter dish or 8 milliliters per 10-centimeter dish. Repeat this procedure once a day when changing the media. If you wish to remove the markings, rub 100% ethanol on the bottom of the dish. Alternatively, you can leave the markings and use a marker of a different color to mark the new regions in the following day. This will allow you to assess whether you have more or less spontaneous differentiation from one day to the next.